Today's topic is sales techniques in OT industry, front office systems. In continuation to the previous sales techniques, the next are OTAs, that is online travel agencies, Meta, that is for Meta search engines, and GDS, that is the global distribution systems. GDS stands for global distribution system and might be considered the dinosaurs of the online travel world. They are first created by airline companies during the 1950s to broaden hotel and car rental businesses by enabling automated transactions between travel service providers and travel agencies, traditional and online. The three biggest GDS systems are Madras, Sabre and Galileo. The travel agencies use GDS to get real-time availability and preferred rates on flight tickets, hotel rooms and car rentals all over the world, and it allows them to be very reactive when asked for a quote. Hotels usually sell their rooms for 30% cheaper on GDS compared to public rates. Central reservation systems, that is CRS, such as Sabre, allow hotels to sell their rooms at all GDS simultaneously. However, it is up to the hotel whether to connect with one or two GDS directly without the need for CRS. GDS is a rather costly selling channel that mainly allows the sale of rooms in larger quantities to bigger companies, for corporate guests or travel agencies, leisure travelers. Thus, small independent hotels usually do not need GDS. OTAs, that is online travel agencies. OTA stands for Online Travel Agency, and today plays a significant role in the travel industry. With the rise of the internet, many websites began selling rooms without the need for human interaction. These sites very quickly gained important market share, and there are many examples of them on the internet. Travelers find these websites useful as they can compare rates, reviews and availability of many different accommodation options at one glance and book them quickly and easily in just a few clicks. Your hotel can usually be listed on an OTA free of charge by adding your hotel's photographs, descriptions, rooms, rates, etc. You can then choose how many rooms you would like to sell through the OTA. The availability you would like to sell as well as the room rate is your decision, and although appearing on the OTA is free, you will have to pay a commission of approximately 15-20% every time you get a booking. Meta search engines are becoming important in the travel agent industry. They were created shortly after OTAs and display the current rates of many different hotels in a given destination. So what's the difference between these and the OTAs? Different rates for the same hotel on the same date and same room type might appear on meta search engines, because meta search engines are in fact taking the place from many different OTAs. With travelers using the internet more than ever to search and book hotels, it is imperative that you work toward a strong online presence for your hotel. Travelers no longer search only for one keyword or click on one result to book their accommodation. They usually do many different searches and visit several websites. The more your name pops up to potential guests, the more they'll start to think, hey, this hotel must be the place to stay. Increasing your online hotel visibility can be done in many ways. For small independent hotels, GDS is usually too costly to be considered. Today, OTAs are a must, and although meta search engines are slightly more technical to manage, they can be also an attractive selling channel to consumers. The cruise industry has become so diversified and complex that finding a simplistic definition for it is difficult. However, studies and guides for the industry by the Cruise Line International Association defines a cruise on sea as a trip on a ship which has been purposefully styled as a floating leisure environment. The cruise industry becomes the traditional offerings of travel and hospitality in one product by offering luxury accommodation and entertainment, as well as the opportunity to explore new destinations. These ships range in small, from size small private yachts to 220-ton behemoths, which are traveling resorts capable of accommodating several thousand passengers at a time. The duration of cruises also range from minimum of typical 2 days to months. Cruising is a unique tourism product, a blend of 5 A's, that are attractions, activities, access, accommodation, amenities. Railways and tourism. No one offers the multidimensional magic of the real India more excitingly than the Indian Railways. The royal trains like Palace on Wheels and Golden Chariot train offers both luxury and signifies the rich culture of our country. These royal trains are well customized trip, which gives the tourist detailed picture of the particular state. This slow yet steady tracks takes the tourist through the lows of the Indian desert and the highs of the Aravalli range. The toy trains of India have attracted many of the tourists. They ride on the trains through the popular hill stations of Shimla, Darjeeling, Ooty, a really mesmerizing one. Airlines, direct network. A direct network is one where there is a direct service from one airport to another without a stop in a third airport. It is optionally used under the following circumstances. Distance between two cities is small. Demand between two cities is high. Total number of cities served by the airline is small. We will continue sales techniques in my next lecture and see GDS in details. Thank you.